Vesicular stomatitis. Also called sporadic aphthous, pseudo foot and mouth disease and mouth thrush. It is an infectious viral disease of bovine, equine and pigs too. Clinically characterized by lesions on dorsal tongue, dental pads, lips and buccal mucosa that often contains serous fluid. Causative agent, belong to the family Rhabdoviridae of genus vesicular virus. There are two major types that cause vesicular stomatitis. 1. Vesicular stomatitis New Jersey. 2. Indiana virus. New Jersey is more virulent and more common than Indiana virus. Subtypes of Indiana virus, Indiana 1 is also called classical virus. Indiana 2 is also called the coccal virus. Indiana 3 is also called Alagoas virus. Epidemiology, it occurs as an endemic in Central and some parts of South America. Also reported as Indian in origin. All breeds of bovine, equine and pigs are susceptible but occurs as an outbreak in bovines, sheep and goats are resistant to the infection. Morbidity rate, it's up to 5-7% but mortality is rare. Transmission, direct contact with the infected animal, indirect through food, water and intimate objects also spread through mechanical way through insects. Pathogenicity, enters the body either through abrasions on the skin, mucous membrane or through insect bites, then there is vesicle formation at the site of infection, virus spread occurs through extension of primary lesions. The virus spread to the other parts of the body and reach the udder and the feet where is causes lesions. Clinical findings, in case of bovines, incubation period is 2-8 days with an average of 3-5 days. There is a sudden occurrence of mild fever. The affected animal shows 102 to 103 degree Fahrenheit temperature, development of vesicles on dorsal tongue and dental pads. When these vesicles rupture they produce irritation and ropey salivation and in milking animals there is a decrease in the milk production. Lesions on the foot region and udder occur rarely except in milking cows where teat lesions are extensive and may lead to the development of mastitis. Recovery from the infection is very fast. Affected animals mostly recovers within 3-10 days and there are less chances of secondary bacterial infections. In case of equines, signs and symptoms are mostly similar like bovines. Affected animals show fever, depression, slight anorexia and salivation. When the horse rubs its lips with some hard object these vesicles rupture and convert to ulcer or may deep ulcer. The lesions above the foot region just above the hoof may lead toward lameness or hoof deformity. Differential diagnosis, bovine viral diarrhea, BVD, lesions and diarrhea. PPR, it is a disease of sheep and goat. Blue tongue, sheep and goat. Rabies, behavioral changes. Actinomycosis, hard connective tissues involved. Actinobacillosis, soft tongue tissues are involved. Diagnosis, on the basis of clinical signs. Tests will be VNT, ELISA, RT-PCR. Treatment, no specific treatment, only symptomatic and supportive treatment. If fever NSAIDS may be used. Multivitamins, Celavit. Wash oral lesion with light potassium permanganate solution in water. After 30 minutes apply glycerin. Prevention and control, separation of the animal from the healthy animal, strict biosecurity measures, control of insects by insecticides. Humans can also get infected and may show headache, fever and flu-like symptoms. Thank you.